G'day. Bruce has asked me to do a small video on how to paint the middle ground of a painting. You will notice that Patricia and I are practicing social distances. Okay, well, I'll bring the picture up on the computer where here we are, and we can do a lot of things with this. We can fiddle around with the lighting here. We can make the colour a bit darker that way, or we can bring that back that way. The colour we can change. We can even go dark to black and white. And that's actually useful in some cases, because then you can get the different tone values. You've got lighter in the mountains there, you've got a dark down at the bottom of the mountains, and now you've got this darker group of trees there, followed by the mangroves and a little man in the boat. Put the color back again to where it should be. We can do a number of things, and it brings our attention to a number of things. First of all, the sun must be pretty close to the horizon over in this area here, because the light is only hitting the tops of these mountains and the very, very tops of these trees. And you have an anomaly here where you have the mountains in the background are of a warmer value than mangroves and trees. And this is because they are collecting the last rays of the sun in the evening. So what we will do is we will try and paint that scene. I made a bit of a sketch here showing the same sort of scene. A little bit different, but it's enough to show you what I mean. And I will start with the paint. The first thing we'll do is just slightly dampen the sky. I don't want to do too much because we want to be able to take out some clouds. So I've got a colour here which I think is probably what I want. And so I will start putting a wash. Remember that the sun is coming from right to left, and we have quite a dark part. And I'll just put a little bit of raw sienna. Raw sienna down there. And we'll wait for a little bit for it to dry, and I will take some clouds out of it with a bit of tissue and just pull a few clouds out of it. And we've noticed that they're gone, and we can go on more colour down here, and right to the water's edge we can take that colour. Okay, we can let that dry now. Okay, what I've done is lightly dampened the mountains, which is actually, and I'm going to drop in a bit of the raw sienna.
I really need
to outline the mountain.
Thank you.
above the tree line. I don't want to go down to the tree line. I want these mountains to stick out a bit above the tree line. Now this is the lightest colour from the mountains, and we'll use a darker tone in a minute. Just dropping these colours into the outline. Now we can add in a bit more colour for the bottom of the mountains. See how the colour is actually working for you. It's just painting itself virtually. And the time being, that's about all we need to do. And Trish can go back to her sewing while I work out the next little bit of this painting. This mountain is a little bit closer to us, so it's a bit warmer. This one is a little bit further away, so we can cool it down a bit on this back side. Cool him down a bit. And these guys a little bit further away. Okay. Side of my brush, I'm going to do the trees that are on the bank.
It's difficult to see your hand when you do the side of your brush.
Now I will make that a darker colour. And drop some darks into it. I'm going to What I'm doing now is just putting a bit of light yellow into the tops of the mangroves. And then I'll mix a little bit blue with the yellow to do the body of the mangroves. Just dropping it in. At the bottom of the mangroves is a little bit of brown mud that you can see there, which we'll leave. Body to it. And below that, I'm going to put a little bit of mud, because it is sitting in the mud. So a little bit of mud down the bottom here. And then for the last bit, we do the sea. Now the sea is just reflecting the dark blue of the sky. And there's no sunlight on the sea, so it'll be mainly dark blue. There's a little patch of light just near this fella's canoe. But generally speaking, it is just one wash of blue. So what we'll do is we'll stop. Now what we do now is we rub off the rubber masking that we put on before, and there's the little man there. So we've got to paint him. So give him a red canoe. Leave a little thin line of white there. Okay. Well, that's the finished product. Not brilliant, but at least it gives you some idea. Just remember that when you are putting paint on your paper, make sure that you're putting it into wet
paper.
Yeah. It could be wet, yeah. And let it run. Don't dab stuff and then into dry paper. Put it into wet paper and let it run and let it do its own thing. I hope this has been helpful. Keep fit.
I've just given them the top of his head back again. I'll cut it off. Okay.
Okay.